You've got more questions and I've got more answers. So let's jump back into the internet's most asked questions about tarantulas. Welcome back to the Tarantula Collective. My name is Richard, and I make videos about tarantulas, scorpions, and other invertebrates and exotic pets. I upload new videos every Tuesday and Friday, so if you don't want to miss out, make sure you're subscribed. This is part two in a three-part series answering the internet's most asked questions about tarantulas. But first, I am out here in the middle of the forest because it seemed like an appropriate location to thank the sponsor of today's video, as well as a longtime supporter of the channel, and that is Micro Wilderness. You see what I did there? MicroWilderness.com is an online tarantula dealer here in the United States, and they are currently in the midst of their biggest sale of the year. Now, through August 9th, you can get 21% off your order during their August fire sale by using the code SUMMER21 at checkout. But if you're watching this after August 9th, don't worry. You can still save 10% off your entire order by using the code TTC10 all year round. They have a large selection of tarantulas and even some scorpions and true spiders, including jumping spiders. They even have some very cool species of millipedes available, including one of my favorite species, the Texas Gold Desert Millipede. So head over to microwilderness.com and use the codes below to save some extra money and tell Wilderness Nate that the Tarantula Collective sent you. We have no time to waste, so let's go ahead and jump into the next question. And this is one that I get asked all the time in the comments under pictures and videos and emails and private messages. I mean, you name it. People always want to know this. And that is, can I hold my pet tarantula? And the answer is yes, but the question should actually be, should I hold my pet tarantula? This is a hotly debated topic on many tarantula forums, with people on one side adamant about handling tarantulas, and those on the other that strongly believe tarantulas should never be handled. Like most controversial topics, many people find themselves somewhere in the middle, meaning they do not go out of their way to handle their tarantulas, but if the tarantula were to climb onto their hands while feeding or rehousing, they may take advantage of the opportunity and let the spider walk around on them and maybe even take a few photos. Generally, tarantulas are split up into two categories. You have Old World and New World species. New Worlds being tarantulas from the Western Hemisphere, so North, Central, and South America, while Old World species are found everywhere else. Old World tarantulas are known to be faster, more defensive, and have stronger venom, so the general consensus is that they should never be handled, but there are always some people that will attempt to handle them anyways. New World species in general are more docile, usually slower moving, and typically have weaker venom, so they are the species most likely to be handled. But New World tarantulas also have urticating hairs, which are small hairs that the tarantula can kick off or rub off their abdomens, and when they get lodged into your skin, can be very uncomfortable. And I have an entire video on urticating hairs that I'll link above if you want more information on them. But even with all this, not handling tarantulas is more for the safety of the tarantula than it is the person. Anytime you approach your tarantula, they will most likely perceive you as a predator they either need to avoid or defend against. Tarantulas are very sensitive to vibrations and movement, especially the bottoms of their feet, and can recognize immediately that they are crawling on something that is alive, as they can feel the warmth, the movement of muscles under the skin, and possibly even sense the blood flowing through your veins. So it can be a stressful experience for them that they will most likely try to escape from by bolting, lunging, or some species can even jump away. Doing so could cause a tarantula to escape your grasp and will send them falling to the floor. Depending on the species and size, a fall of more than 6 inches or so could be fatal, as a tarantula's abdomen could rupture, killing your pet tarantula. Knowing all of this, if you are still insistent on handling your tarantulas or just want to know the best way to handle them in case they were ever to crawl up onto your hands, I have an entire video about how to handle your tarantula that will give you a lot more information that I will link at the end of this video. Since we're answering controversial questions, we might as well take care of this one as well. And that is, can you crossbreed tarantulas to get cool new species or color morphs? It is important to know that tarantulas are different species. They are not breeds or morphs within the same species that can be bred to bring out specific characteristics. Most species of tarantula cannot be successfully crossbred and will usually end up with the male being eaten. Closely related species in the same genus can be bred together successfully, though this is never seen as a good thing. There is a desire or interest to attempt to crossbreed species to come up with cool new tarantula morphs. That is usually an idea brought over from people that initially keep or breed reptiles. They think it will be interesting or even profitable to come up with a new type of tarantula. For the most part, no one that really keeps tarantulas would ever be interested in buying these hybrids. With over 1,000 different species of tarantula, they already come in a huge variety of shapes, sizes, colors, patterns, and behaviors. And it would be very difficult for anyone to actually keep every single species of tarantula that is available. So there is really no need to intentionally create new species. Crossbreeding tarantulas only hurts the hobby and causes confusion. In the past, there has definitely been some unintentional crossbreeding of species due to specimens being incorrectly labeled or misidentified. The issue is that the offspring usually aren't infertile and then will grow and be bred with pure blood specimens. And then those tarantulas will be bred, and eventually the entire species in the hobby is different from the species in the wild. If someone were to intentionally crossbreed two different species and then sell the spiderlings as a hybrid or new morph, the majority of people that keep tarantulas would not buy those spiderlings and would most likely be very vocal in protest that those species were even being put up for sale, which would most likely lead to the person attempting to sell them to relabel them as purebred specimens and sold with no mention that they are hybrids or hobby form, further diluting the species in the hobby. So even though crossbreeding may have happened unintentionally in the past and may happen again in the future, it definitely isn't something that should be intentionally done by hobbyists, as it adds no real value to the hobby and only causes problems. Of course, someone out there is yelling at their screen right now.
What about hybridization in nature? I'm sure some species crossbreed in the same area from time to time.
And that may be true, but it would be a naturally occurring situation. And based on natural selection, those specimens would either thrive or die off. We are not Mother Nature, and we should not attempt to be. We do not know better than nature, and just because we can do something does not mean that we should. We should leave the business of evolution and adaptation to Mother Nature and just enjoy the species that are available as they are. Now, this is a very popular question that I've answered in the past in other videos, but we're gonna hit it today as well. And that is, which species of tarantula makes the best pet? This question has many answers, and I have an entire video with my picks of the best tarantula that you can get as your first species that I will link above. It includes the top 10 species most highly suggested, as well as 10 species that are also very good tarantulas, but are commonly overlooked. Generally though, you want to get a species that is hardy, easy to care for, mostly docile, and slow moving. This describes many species in the Gramostola, Brachypelma, and Afanopelma genera. Of course, there are other species that are in a different genus that would also make a great beginner species. So make sure you watch my video on beginner tarantulas to get more information. It is important to note though that temperament or behaviors attributed to a specific species are a generalization. Tarantulas seem to have their own personalities, so to speak, meaning that even a specimen from a species known to be very docile can still be defensive. There are always exceptions, and every tarantula, no matter the species, should be dealt with cautiously. Tarantulas have even been known to completely change their personality after a molt. So a very defensive tarantula can become mostly docile after a molt and vice versa. And in between molts, a tarantula can be very calm one day and then be very feisty or skittish the next, which is why it is always important to respect your tarantula and always check their temperament before attempting to rehouse, handle, or even when conducting maintenance in their enclosure. Now, this next question I get asked way too often, so let's just nip it in the bud right now. And that is, what species of tarantula do I have? This is one of the most asked questions on the internet. It comes from the use of common names by pet stores and some online dealers. The issue with common names is that there is no standardized, agreed upon list that is the same around the world. Different countries, cultures, and even regions have different common names for the same species. For example, look at the Afanopelma hinsi, known as the Texas brown, Oklahoma chocolate, Missouri tarantula, Colorado brown. Essentially, any state the tarantula can be found in has a different common name for it. The Afanopelma chalcodes is known as the desert blonde and the Arizona blonde. This is even more muddled with a lot of Mexican species of Brachypelma and Afanopelma, with the common names red knee, red leg, fire leg, blood leg, and flame knee being attributed to multiple species. Recently, I released a video on the Brachypelma erratum, which is most commonly known as as the Mexican flame-kneed tarantula, but I received a lot of very angry and condescending comments from people that believed its common name is the red-kneed tarantula, and they were very upset at me, thinking I was either an idiot or trying to change the common name on my own. This is not limited to North American species, as nearly all species of tarantula have more than one common name, and most of the time, common names are created by either the people living in the same area as the tarantula or by breeders and dealers in the pet hobby that are coming up with a name much easier to say than the scientific name. On top of all this confusion, tarantulas are regularly mislabeled or misidentified by pet shops selling tarantulas as they do not know the specific species and try and guess by comparing it to pictures of tarantulas online and find the common name of a spider that looks fairly similar. There are a lot of different species of tarantula that appear to look similar at a passing glance. Some are even so similar it can take an expert looking at very specific details, like whether there is hair on the underside of a segment of their leg, to determine which species it actually is, or even requiring looking at a molt under magnification to determine between two different species. Sometimes the answer to that question can be very easy to find, and other times can be quite difficult. So if you are wondering what species your tarantula might be, it is important, necessary in fact, to take the clearest, most detailed pictures you possibly can. Blurry, out of focus, low quality photos taken through dirty glass or acrylic of your spider can sometimes be completely useless when asking this question. So get the best possible photos of your tarantulas as you can and post the images along with any information you have about them, like what common or scientific name they were sold to you as, where you got them, when you got them, what size they are in the picture, any behaviors they may exhibit. All that information, along with good pictures, will definitely help in identifying the species. And post this info along with your questions on tarantula forums like Arachnoboards or tarantula Facebook groups. It is better to get feedback from a wide range of people with different expertise and experiences than from one individual person, unless that person happens to be an arachnologist. And please don't send me those questions. I get 3 or 4 messages every day asking me to identify species. And usually they're sending very blurry photos of their tarantulas, sometimes from far away, asking me to identify the species of their tarantula. For one, I am not an entomologist, a breeder, and I have no degrees in biology. And even with my experience keeping many tarantulas for many years, I cannot always identify the specific species, especially between species that look very similar. I also do not always have the time to respond to and do the necessary research to answer every question like this. This is why I created a Facebook group where people can post questions and experiences and get help and information from a wide variety of people with many different backgrounds and resources. Crowdsourcing help is much easier than relying on one single person. But all of this underlies the importance of using scientific names over common names. Common names are definitely easier to remember and pronounce, but they are highly unreliable and not consistent around the world. Scientific names describe a very specific species, and even though tarantula species can be reclassified and renamed, when that happens, it is universally accepted in most cases. So if you want to know specifically what species of tarantula you have, it is always best to use scientific names. And our last question today is, do tarantulas make good pets? And obviously, I'm going to say the answer is yes. Tarantulas are, for the most part, very easy to take care of and are one of the few pets out there that almost benefit more from you leaving them alone than constantly interacting with them. True, they cannot recognize you or show you love or loyalty like a dog or bird or other pet, but they are fascinating to observe and very rewarding to keep, especially if you have a fear of spiders. Most fear comes from the unknown. And keeping a tarantula gives you the ability and opportunity to learn more about them and their behaviors. Time and time again, people that have a fear of spiders that got a pet tarantula quickly learn they are not nearly as frightening and intimidating as they first thought. Usually, tarantulas are very timid and shy, and are more apt to run and hide from human interaction than to get defensive. Keeping a tarantula is much like having a plant or keeping fish in an aquarium. You provide them water and food, and then mostly leave them alone and observe. You will have to move them into larger enclosures as they get bigger. But for the most part, if you keep their basic needs met, they will thrive and live for years. And the less you interact with them, the less stressed they are, and the more active they usually become. If you're looking for a pet that will interact with you that you can hold and pet and snuggle with, then tarantulas are not your best option. But if you are looking for a pet that is fun to observe, easy to maintain, does not stink or make a lot of noise, then a tarantula is the best pet for you. Now, if you want to continue watching this series where I answer the internet's most asked questions about tarantulas, just click this playlist right here. But if you would prefer to watch the videos I referenced in this episode, just click this playlist right here. As always, I appreciate you watching. Subscribe if you want to see more. Only buy captive bred tarantulas, and I will see you next time.